I'm Tim Zakowski. The premise of this show is simple. I have conversations with entertainers that no one's ever heard of. I'll be shooting the breeze with actors, directors, writers, comedians, athletes, musicians. Simple entertainment. Hi, welcome to Anybody Who Ain't Anybody. My name's Tim Zakowski, and today we're on stage at Mark Ridley's Comedy Cast on Royal Oak, Michigan, and I'm sitting here with Mark Ridley. Mark,
anybody,
welcome to the show.
Anybody who ain't anybody?
Anybody who ain't anybody,
right,
which is who I am.
Yeah.
I'm not going to push it on you.
Tim's been in the witness protection program for all these years.
So. Oh, this is why my face is blanked out. It looks like this. I don't really look like this at home. Now, you been here for how long? How been in the business for how long?
31 years in January.
Oh, no way. So, 31
yeah.
years.
Yeah. Yep.
So you know a lot of guys. You know a lot of comics.
You've been around
forever.
Over 2 billion laughs served.
Is that what it is?
I figure conservatively.
Conservatively. You don't want to brag.
It's been a good run, and you know, I've been enjoying it all the way. It's not always roses, but you know.
Well, comics are creative people.
Yeah. Yeah.
And everybody thinks they're funnier than everybody else.
Yeah.
Yep. And I know that I happen to be the only one that actually is. You know? Thank you for that.
Tim's kept out of the limelight. Yeah.
That's right. The only time you see me is on this show. Being that I've done some comedy, and I started here.
When did you start doing? Oh, yeah. Okay. All right.
Cut.
But it is tough to do, and you know, you've done well in the past. You've done well, and you've had your bad nights. I've seen those too.
Oh, absolutely. You know, absolutely.
And that's something that every comedian or aspiring comedian has to experience.
And one of the things about you is what I like about it. You tell you the truth. You're honest about it. Like you just said, I've seen you do well, Tim, and I've seen you not do well.
Right. Right.
You know, so that's what you do. You tell the truth. And so when a comic leaves, they know how you feel.
Yeah, absolutely, you know, absolutely.
And if they take it personally, then they're really looking at it wrong?
They really are. I mean, they have to. If you're going to stand up here on stage by yourself trying to make 400 people laugh, you better have a very critical eye back on yourself.
Now, you've spawned quite a few names, people who came through the door, do an open mic,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
for example.
Well, when I started the club in 79, I started in January of 79, and Tim Allen started in February of 79.
Oh, really?
So
okay.
He started doing open mic. I mean, and at that time, there really was, every night was open mic.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? I was only open 3 nights a week, and I had 9 or 10 or 12 comedians that I kind of put it out there for local aspiring comedians to get up on stage. And Dave Coulier was 19 at the time, and he started coming up in March, and it just sort of built from there.
And then
over the years, you know, open mic has been a gym for comedians. But I was fortunate enough early on, Tim, to get, when Make Me Laugh was very popular, to get those comedians that were on the air and plugging their appearance in Detroit. So I get Bob Saget, Gary Shandling.
Oh, yeah. You know, guys. And these guys are huge.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And one of the things, when I sat down on the stage with Bill Hildebrand, mm-hmm. and I took some shots of the headshots, you know, and Jay Leno looked like he was 18 years old when he walked through the door.
That was 1983.
You know,
here
you know the guy, you know who he is long before NBC had any idea who he was, and you know, so that's one of the things that that's why I appreciate you sitting down, because you got comedy stories that if you started telling them now, you'd be dead when you're halfway down.
Well, I mean, you know, that's the great thing about show business is that anybody you meet has great stories if they've been around long enough. And, you know, it's, we talk when I, in fact, I'm not the name drop here, but when Jerry Seinfeld was in town promoting the B-movie that he produced and his voice was in it, and they asked me to come out and introduce him. And I said, he played the club back in 1984. I'm sure he's not going to remember. So this was 2008, 24 years later. I went out to the Imagine Theater in Novi, and I'm in the theater next to where the press corps is, and I'm just waiting to get started. And Jerry walked in, and the first thing he said, he goes, "Mark," he said, "so great to see you again."
Oh,
he goes,
nice.
"You know what I remember about your club? It was in the basement of a restaurant. I stayed in this great apartment that was close by, which I did. I had a nice apartment. And he said, you loaned me your car, and he named the car. And I went, right. Now, who would remember that 24
yeah.
years later?
Yeah, yeah.
So, you know, you have a story about somebody who appreciated, and that's what a lot of people tell me, they appreciate being treated nicely, so they'll remember those things.
No, and it's when you come in here, I like the idea of, well, you know, being a comic and being funny. And you, what you, I think you opened here for the first 10 years. You were the opening act. I was MC.
I was MC yeah. for 14 years.
For 14
right.
years.
Right.
So
right.
you understand getting up in front of an audience.
That's right.
There's things that you know about the business that a lot of club owners don't know because they're not comics.
Right.
They're just businessmen.
Right.
You know. And so that's why we appreciate Mark Ridley, because, well, he understands this stuff. If you have a bad night, it doesn't mean, you know, you'll never come back here again.
Right.
You know, as a...
That's right.
You know, you'll talk to him because you've said, okay, be careful of this, be careful of that.
That's right. That's right.
And next time, be funny.
Well, you know, it is. Look, it is important. And then there are comedians who work well or compliment that whoever the headliner is. Everything is done in a progression. You know, there's an opening act, a middle act, and a headliner, and that opening act better complement the
right.
middle act, and the middle act should complement the headliner.
Right.
And the most important thing, we hold classes, Tim, on how to be a good MC. And
yeah.
a lot of people don't realize that MC is really who sets the tone for the evening.
Right.
You know, it's not just a matter of getting up and doing your act and offending that person and alienating everybody out there. It's embracing them, breaking down that wall and saying, you know, hey, you're here to have a good time. Oh, by the way, here, you know, don't forget to tip your waitress and fill out the email comment cards.
They have a job to do.
Yes.
And some of it is to be funny.
Mm-hmm.
But some of it is to introduce the audience to a night of having some fun.
Right.
The way I was taught was an MC would be a guy who, maybe he's a game show host personality.
Yeah.
Hey, how
yeah.
you doing? Welcome to the club. We're going right. to have a great time tonight. And you see people come on and go, hi.
Yeah.
Okay, well, tonight we're going to do this. And
I hate this.
You know,
I don't want to be the MC. I want to be the middle.
I'm way funnier than these
yeah,
guys.
Yeah, right,
trust
exactly.
me, but I need the work.
Yes.
And there's no energy. And they just...
Right.
dig a hole for the next person.
Mm-hmm.
And then they wonder why they can't come back.
Mm-hmm.
There's so many people that are funny off stage. They make their friends and family laugh and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
And they can't recreate it up here.
Right.
That's one of the things. That there's this really funny story and you tell and nobody's laughing. You know,
yeah.
I guess you got to be there.
Well, I don't know Uncle Fred.
You know,
I don't
yeah.
know Aunt Betty.
And as a comic, you have to take them there.
Right.
You know, you guess
right.
you had to be there. No, that doesn't work.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, so, and that's what Kathleen Madigan does. I mean,
mm-hmm.
she'll just take you right to her living room with her dad and her brother.
That's right. You can visualize
man,
those brothers and parents.
You know,
parents.
You can hear
that's
the
right.
belches and, you know, and it's just, you know, you just know where she's coming from.
Lewis is a great example. Lewis Black told me the story about for years and years and years doing the club scene, traveling around, you know, writing one-man plays, he's known as a playwright too. But he would travel with and not do what he does now, which is like that anger, curmudgeon-y, selling it, you
right,
know?
Right.
And somebody finally said one day, says, you have all the material and I'm doing all the yelling. Why don't you try that approach?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It was that simple?
It was an opening act. Said, you know, you stand up there
yeah,
and you
yeah.
do, you're angry. You're the angry young, the angry man telling the audience what's wrong with the world and politics and everything else, but you're not selling it. So he said, yeah, I'll try that. So that's when he came up with this, you know, and that people took to it.
Well, I didn't actually step away from stand-up. I just started doing stage plays and acting.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then I started doing this show, and I really like doing this show.
Yeah, do a
you
good
know,
job
it's
at
kind
it.
Of an easy, playful shoot the breeze. I think
yeah.
I shoot the breeze better than I do
right.
stand-up is
right.
my
right.
thought, you know.
You like to talk.
Thank you. Interrupt me again and you're gone. Mark Ridley. Very
Thank
gracious.
You, Tim.
Very
appreciate
gracious.
It. Thank you, sir.
I appreciate you sitting down with me.
No problem.
We'll have to do it again.
Anybody who...
anybody who ain't anybody.
No, anybody. All right.
Don't be nobody.
Don't
no
be no...
So, once again, thank you very much, Mark.
Thank you, Tim.
Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. All right. That was recording, right?
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Don't make me get Mark to kill you.